You're watching the First News Hour debate on Times Now Super Prime Time.
On the Super Prime Time debate number one this evening, Dr. Subramaniam Swamy and Sanjay Jha from the BJP and the Congress respectively. Remember, there's a political twist to this, with the BJP insinuating something about Kapil Sibal's alleged involvement or partial ownership of the Helka, which Kapil Sibal hit back on today. And we'll come to that political aspect in some time. Dilip Tahil, I don't know. I've been told he's supporting Tarun Tejpal. I don't know why. I see no justifiable reason for him to do something as ridiculous as that, but that's his call. Dilip Tahil will be defending himself in some time. Sankarshan Thakur was formerly executive editor of the Helka. He's joining us this evening. He's now roving editor of the Telegraph newspaper of Kolkata. Ex-editor of the Hindu and one of India's best respected journalists, Siddharth Vardarajan, joining us from Delhi. He has stood by the victim side from day one. Senior and respected journalist Ajay Bose. So my first question goes to Vrinda Grover. You know, Vrinda Grover, what is most shocking to me today is Shoma Chaudhary's hypocrisy. I mean, look at it here. She knew all this. She talks of feminist politics. You know, she talks about what she has done and her body of work speaking for itself. Here you have the victim talking about how she was begging Tarun Tejpal to stop. But Shoma Chaudhary was trying to organize a six-month laceration for Tarun Tejpal. Isn't that hypocrisy, Shoma Chaudhary's hypocrisy, the biggest story today that comes out, the most important development after this email comes in the public domain?
Well, I think for me the most important development does remain that what is now very clear to all of us, that rape, sexual harassment is committed by all kinds of men, including men who claim to be progressive, liberal, including in offices which purportedly stand up for women's rights, which bring out issues on women's rights. The aspect of Shoma Chaudhary as managing editor is quite clear that she failed in all her duties. She failed in her duty to protect her employee. She failed in her duty to set up mechanisms that would provide redress or justice. And she clearly failed in any kind of feminist principles.
I remember debating the subject with you 2 days after this whole incident broke out. In fact, I think within 24 hours of this incident breaking out, Vrinda Grover, you were on one of my programs, and you know, you were pleading there for the sexual harassment committee that was supposed to be set up at that point of time under Urvashi Bhotalia to be given an opportunity. Now, do you believe that your position at that point of time was a wrong position to take, given all that has emerged?
No, I do not believe.
You don't think so?
I think we need to understand that this story has developed. At that time, that is what I can only respond to what is in the public domain. We were told that that is what the woman complainant had asked as remedy and redress. Now we know that this is a case of rape, and therefore what is...
At that point of time, you believed what Shoma Chaudhary had said. Why did you believe her point of view? Why did you not look upon her as a party who could have been involved in a abysmal, circle of self-interest, trying to protect herself? Because, you know, that the victim had to come out and challenge it. But initially, everyone, including you, Vrinda Grover, especially you went with Shoma Chaudhary's argument that the girl was satisfied.
I did not go with Shoma Chaudhary's argument
then
that the girl
argument?
Was satisfied. Please do not. You have to let somebody complete an answer. I'm not in the interrogation box. The person in the dock is Tarun Tejpal. Make no mistake of that. At that point of time, we did not know. I am only privy to what is in the public domain. I'm not privy to anything else. If the woman is saying, I want to take time to take a decision and then I will decide which way I will go, I will stand by her and provide her support. And that is the way feminists and feminist lawyers work. You need to understand that. Now we know this is a case of rape. The police has stepped in. The courts of law will have to prosecute Tarun Tejpal. There is no scope for any complaints committee to be placed.
At that point of time,
the woman has said.
At that point of time, Ms. Grover, I'm not holding you accountable. I understand that the person at fault here. I'm not trying to put you in the dock. Don't get me wrong. All that I'm saying is that I'm rather surprised, Sankarshan. Now let me go to Sankarshan. I'm rather surprised that a very powerful and influential section. A powerful and influential section at that point of time, instead of looking upon Shoma Chaudhary as an interested party who would go to any extent to protect us, her own interest, including, as it is now revealed, her financial interest by being a co-partner in the company that organizes the Think Fest, that instead of understanding that she's probably defending her interest, took her at face value. Why did everybody in Delhi take her at face value? That's my question. Let those in Delhi who supported her
answer that. Nobody took her at face value. People were asking her, to do what the law requires.
No. People were asking. No, they were not asking.
I have no information about what the financial dealings are or aren't.
Maybe you
have access to them as
well. It's in the public domain. Everyone knows about it. Well, Sankarshan Thakur, how do you read it? You know, what in your view are the bigger questions that have emerged now?
Arnab, if you remember, I was on the first program that you did on this issue, and I had spoken that day of how this issue was sought to be fixed by Shoma Chowdhury on the editorial floor. I know that contention has been questioned by Shoma Chowdhury as saying, on what authority? I knew it on the authority of some Tehelka journalists who were in those meetings where this whole thing was sought to be brushed under the carpet in the crudest fashion. And now, absolutely, and I said this on the first day.
And Shoma Chowdhury named you.
Under the purview of the law. Yes, she did. But the authority that I was speaking on, and I totally agree with this lady who's been so horribly wronged, is that what I have been speaking, and I have been coming on these programs partly for the reason that what this lady...
No, I find Brinda's disagreeing with you. I don't know on what point.
There are a lot of...
No, okay.
A lot of Tehelka journalists, the good work they have done. It has been totally desecrated, and I agree with this young lady.
No, but there was
always needed to go straight away under the purview of the law.
Which they didn't.
Because it was very clear from the beginning that the Tehelka editorial management staff was trying to hush it up.
Which they did not.
I have no doubt in my mind.
Which they did not.
And subsequent flip-flops and this whole effort, you know, this whole mumbo-jumbo about secularism and BJP and non-BJP. I mean, if Indian secularism, Arnab, is riding Tarun Tejpal and Shoma Chowdhury's shoulders, Indian secularism should shudder. It should be very afraid of itself now.
Well, I completely back that.
Mumbo-jumbo of dividing secularism and BJP and Congress conspiracy. I am no defender of the Congress party or of the BJP. But the point is, Indian secularism is a far bigger thing than they are seeking to make.
I don't understand. I have never understood. Even his bail application
is so self-congratulatory. The foremost critic of right-wing majoritarianism, as if he's the only man who has upheld Indian secularism. I mean, God forbid. What is this kind of pomposity that he's still playing out in the public space?
Since you made a reference to it, and with apologies to Siddharth and Ajay Bose and Dilip Tahil, I was about to come to you, but since Sankarshan referred to the politics of it, let's ask the politicians before I come to you. You know, Subramaniam Swami, there are two ways of looking at it, right? One way of looking at it is a terrible sheath of secularism that an accused like Tarun Tejpal is trying to put over himself, which you have every right to do so, and I have a right to ask that question as well. My question is, what about Sushma Swaraj? Why did Sushma Swaraj mention this thing about a union minister having an interest in Tehelka? And if she was so sure about it, why did she not directly name Kapil Sibal? Because Kapil Sibal challenged her too. You're making it political, aren't you? I mean, you don't need to make this political.
No, if there is a minister who's supporting Tejpal, I think Sushma Swaraj has a right to bring it to the public domain.
How do you know he's supporting?
Today,
she doesn't name Kapil Sibal.
Well, I mean, this is Sushma Swaraj's view. She has expressed it, and it's not necessary for her to go to a national executive meeting of the BJP and get a resolution passed as a party stand. She is a leader of the opposition. She has expressed her view, and she has not named anybody.
She didn't express her view. She says a union cabinet minister who is the founder and patron of Tehelka is shielding Tarun Tejpal. Right? She talks about who...
Yes.
She didn't name Kapil Sibal.
See, the question is, listen, there is a lot of Congress support for Tejpal that is known because the first letter after the government was formed in 2004 was written by Ms. Sonia Gandhi herself to the Prime Minister on June 18, 2004. And the Prime Minister replied saying that in her letter she wanted him to look into the questions of all the investigations that are ongoing against Mr. Tejpal.
Shooting in the dark, Subramaniam Swami? Shooting in the dark?
What do you mean shooting in the dark?
Obviously shooting in the dark.
What more do you want? Shooting in the dark is only happens in Times Now.
No, of course.
But I have produced a letter in a press conference.
It's shooting in the dark, Mr. Subramaniam Swamy. Why doesn't, if she feels her, first of all, if she was sure about it, why didn't she name Kapil Sibal? That's question number one. Question number two, was she worried about being contradicted strongly, which she was? Question number three, the BJP or Subramaniam Swamy or Sushma Swaraj or Arun Jaitley, nobody has questioned the Trinamool Congress Member of Parliament, K.D. Singh, who owns a majority stake in a company, which proves that you are using this issue for petty politics.
Not to name Ms. Sonia Gandhi made a speech the other day, say that some leaders of the BJP speak lies. Now, who did she talk about? Why didn't she name them? Who are the liars? I was not the one who faked my educational degree or my name or place of birth.
No, you see, this is not a playground for your politics.
This is a common thing in politics to not name people. I named them. I certainly named them. I named that in the press conference today. I will say, let us look at the fact that today rape has become an epidemic. And it has become a crisis for the liberal left wing, which has been having an incestuous relationship with those in power. And suddenly they are now under the glare of the media and they are finding it very uncomfortable. And in the case of Tejpal, in 2005, he had tried to get the best bad sex book award in Britain for writing a lewd book. Then 2001, he says, sleep with anyone you like. I mean, as if this is a sex is a one-way traffic.
But this is what Tarun Tejpal has said. Subramaniam Swamy, this is what Tarun Tejpal has said. If you want to say somebody is an accomplice after what Tejpal has said, you can say Shoma Chaudhary is an accomplice there because she was trying to cover up for him. But you are almost suggesting it's the Congress party which is responsible for what Tarun Tejpal has said. Let's get the Congress to counter you, Sanjay Jha.
I am not saying Congress party has abated it. But Congress party is providing the umbrella for his hubris.
He thought
he can get away with it.
I will let Mr. Jha respond to you. I don't want to make it a playground for politics, but it has become one. So let's debate that part out. Mr. Jha.
You started it.
Arun Jaitley wrote a letter. Sushma Swaraj tweeted. Kapil Sibal came out and you cannot say the media started it.
I can tell you that it's very unfortunate that a terrible social crime like rape is being given some kind of an ideological color here. It's got nothing to do with left or the right. In his own BJP ruled state of Madhya Pradesh, there is the maximum incidence of rape in this country. That's not the point. The point here is very simple. And as you rightly mentioned, Arnab, yourself, the leader of the opposition, this is not a very small individual of the BJP. This is a leader of the opposition, Sushma Swaraj, making a very scathing allegation against an unnamed cabinet minister of India. Now, you're talking about people who have got responsible positions in governance, who have their own reputations to protect. She makes the allegation, does not have the courage, does not have the strength of conviction to name the person concerned. I think the reason why Mr. Sibal mentioned his name, because, I'm very active on social media, Arnab, and over the last couple of days, since November 15th, when the story of Tehelka came out, there has been allusions and innuendos that Kapil Sibal is the owner and he's related. By the way, people have been saying he's related to Tarun Tejpal, which he's trashed today. Now, I think I'll want to make one point here. It's unfortunate that this debate has got a political color, but the truth is that the reason why Sushma Swaraj has mentioned Kapil Sibal, and I will mention this on your channel as a spokesperson of the party, is because the Bharatiya Janata Party is very interested in keeping the entire Tehelka issue and the transcripts alive, because there is a very dangerous explosive transcripts relating to that poster boy Narendra Modi and Amit Shah,
which they haven't denied, despite
putting a hogwash or an eyewash of an inquiry. And the idea is to divert attention from the stock or the snoop gate, whatever you want to call it. I think the BJP is extremely paranoid and they are completely disturbed at the moment. So they are sitting and gloating. They are gloating at the turn of events. And I want to make one point. Last point here, Arnab. As a party, as a Congress party, we strongly condemn. I want to make a point. As a Congress party, we strongly condemn the incident that happened in Goa. The Congress party wants to make it explicit and categorical that the law must take his own course. Tarun Tejpal, if the alleged sexual assault has happened, must face the consequences of his actions.
Now, you know what? You know what?
But the Bharatiya Janata Party
Mr. Jha, before I allow you to also carry on with the self-righteous tone, I'd like to remind you before I go to Siddharth Vadarajan that on November 18th, Jayanti Natarajan, Shobha, Ozas, Rita Bahuguna Joshi and Girija Vyas had the press conference on the snooping scandal. They wanted Narendra Modi to resign. They were completely outraged. They called his question his moral right to compete as a chief prime ministerial candidate. Where is your outrage now?